Hello friends, in the previous videos we are discussed the concept of some pteridophytes, just like what is that, Ophioglossum and Teres and other group of the pteridophytes, and going to the another one, true pteridophyte, or the we call it as a fern, that's a Osmunda. That's a Osmunda is generally referred as Osmunda, that is a royal fern. It's a common fern, usually grow in the greenhouses. Especially these Osmunda is cultivated for their ornamental purposes, and usually commonly grow in moist areas. Especially if you go to the higher altitude, these Osmunda is widely distributed, and even in the temperate and tropical regions of the world, the Osmunda is commonly grow. Especially if you go into the evergreen forest, in the river bed or in the streams bed, this Osmunda is commonly growing, and they develop into the very interesting ornamental pteridophytes, and that's why nowadays these Osmunda is commonly growing in almost all whatever the nurseries, they will grow as a ornamental one. If you look at the morphology of these all Osmunda, generally there will be different species is varies. So few of them are grow up to 2 to 3 meter in height, and the body consists of the that's up rhizome region, and also the sporophytic leafy bearing regions will be present, and usually the sclerotic leaf will be arranged in a spiral manner. Rhizome is unbranched in nature, but sometimes they may also, some of the few species of these Osmunda have the dichotomous branching will be also there. The very peculiar and important characteristic is the leaves. The leaves are spirally at the apex of the rhizome. They are unipinnate, sometimes maybe a bipinnate also in case of the Osmunda regalis, and it will be varies in the length from 0.3 to 0.3 meter to the 3 meter in length, and each leaf has the stout, and they bears the rachis, and they have wing like expansion will be there, and the leaves are deciduous. Every year there will be a fresh leaf will be formed, but the leaf bases are persistent, thick, and usually the they will bears the old rhizomes, and the lamina has leathery texture and covered with the brown hairs. The variation of the dichotomous is occurs. The leaves exhibit the succinate vernation, that's a true characteristic of the ferns. The many of the leaves are monomorphic in nature, that may be only one type of the spores will be present. There is no distinguish between the sterile and the fertile leaves, that means there is no dimorphic occurs, but very few of these Osmunda also occurs the dimorphic, that's in case of Osmunda cinnamonea and japonica, they found in diformic condition, but that is the fertile and sterile leaves are differentiated in the Osmunda japonica, but the majority of them are the monomorphic, that's Osmunda religiosa and Osmunda other species, they are the monomorphic. Especially the chlorophyllous lamina will be absent in case of the fertile leaves, and they bears the cluster of sporangia. But in case of monomorphic leaf, the leaf bears the pinnate and dimorphic condition. The fertile and sterile phyna are various distinct. Going to the reproduction, they are reproduced by the formation of spores. The sporangia are aggregated in certain pinnate only. These fertile pinnae, which have almost lost their foliar nature, and they are commonly called tassels. What are tassels? These are the foliar pinnate, and it occurs in case of the Osmunda. The sporangia aggregated and has not reached the sori organization. All the sporangia of the cluster nature are simultaneously, and the sporophyte is called as tassel in case of the Osmunda. So usually sometime you will examine what is the Tazel, where do you find the Tazels, that's in case of the sporophyte of Osmunda is referred as a Tazel. So this is the structure of the Tazel, that you have to be explain the structure and the development of the sporangia. So if you look at the detailed account of the sporangial development that was discovered by Bower in 1899, the development is intermediate between the eusporangiate and leptosporangiate type. The sporangia trachable and single sporangia is inter. However, the neighboring cells contribute to stock of the sporangium either orally or in a pot. The sporangia initially divides pericleanly to form an outer primary walls. The inner primary archiporous, the shape of this primary archiporous cells is variable. It may be trenched at the base and they form a eusporangiated forms or pointed at the base of the eusporangiate to form a primary archiporous cells. And these primary archiporous cells are functioning like a apical cells, cut off the peripheral cells from the each of its cutting faces, including that the next up to the primary wall cells. Later they have studied that some Bohr and other scientists has pointed out that the tapetal nature, they have the nutritive and supporting to the spore mother cells. These peripheral cells contributed to the wall of the cells and they are the thick layer cells. After cutting off the peripheral cells, the central cells now function as the primary sporogenous cells and they divide repeatedly to form a mass of sporogenous cells and contributed to the tapetum. So this is how actually the maturation of the usually sporangiate will be takes place. That's a chasal condition will be takes place. The mature sporangia is pyriform in shape and reddish brown in color and having the stout stalk. The jacket is one layer thick and have the shield nature. Their pellet like annules will be present in case of the Osmunda. The annules is not very well developed, hence it is often referred as the rudimentary annuals in case of the Osmunda. What happens? So usually Osmunda is not very well developed and it is a rudimentary. There may be traces will be present within the sporangia or spore ranging numbers will be varies. That may be sometime 250 spores in a sporangium will probably up to 500 will be there. And the sporangia dehisces vertically along the stominum and usually spores are wild and dispersed. The gametophyte are monoecious, but underdeveloped ones tend to produce only male sex organs. The male sex is organs usually antheridia and that is next one is the archegonia that occurs on the midrib of the ventral cells. Antheridia occurs towards the fragile of the prothallus. So usually this is how actually the archegonia and antheridia are developed in case of the Osmunda. But you did not get the complete detail account of this their life cycle or the developmental studies. Just for your syllabus you will have the only just how actually this chasal will be formed and the structure of the chasal you will have. But very interesting aspect. So when these gametophyte are monoecious, that means the male is separate to only produce and female will be separately produced in a different thallus. That you have to be differentiate. The male is called antheridia and the female is called archegonia, and when they both will come in contact to form a zygote, that in case of the prothallus only. Okay, this prothallus will develop into a new thallus will be formed. This is how the structure of the chasal in case of the Osmunda. So this is the complete the sporophyte of the chasalia. So what you find in dark color, that's a fertile tree leaves and others will be sterile leaf. These fertile cells will be find, the sorus will be present, and this is common in case of the high altitude region. So this is an complete account of the development, that's a morphology, classification and the detailed morphological structure of the rhizome and the leaf and the reproduction, that's and especially the tessel, the development of the tessels we have covered in this concept. So this is a simple group of the pteridophytes. So just for 2 to 3 marks question generally answer, sometime maybe up to maximum 3 to 5 marks question maybe you can arise in these classes. So maybe for example, what is tessel, explain the structure of the tessel. So give an example for the osmunda and give an example for ornamental fern, and especially the in case of osmunda, they will ask for tessel. What is tessel? That's a sporophyte of the osmunda is called as tessel, and usually they will develop in a sporogenous structure, and this is how the archaeonia and the antheridia produced in a separate structure. That you have to be remember, because the gametophyte are monoecious, but underdeveloped ones tend to produce only male sex organs. Archaeonia occurs near the midrib on the ventral surface of the antheridia, occur towards the fringes of the prothallus. That you have to be determined. So this is an account, complete account of the pteridophyte, that's a osmunda. So if you have doubt, so you can clarify in the next class.